Does this happen to your telescope every time you remove an eyepiece?
Ouch!
Or every time you remove a smartphone camera adapter?
Ouch!
Or whenever you have to remove a cat?
Ouch!
Then this video's for you. Hi everybody, welcome back to the studio here. Almost every telescope will eventually have a balance problem. In this video, I'm going to show you all the simple and easy ways to take care of that. And if you stay till the end, I'll show you a very cheap and simple way to build one of these magnetic counterweights. I have these on all my telescopes. Oh, one more thing. In this video, I'll be using dobsonian style telescopes for all of the demonstrations. The main reason is that this style is generally pretty sensitive to balance issues, so it'll allow me to cover even more fixes and demonstrate the common techniques that are used. So even if you don't have a dobsonian, you can take some of the information you learned in this video and you might be able to apply it to your situation. Pretty much every telescope has its pivot point located at the center of gravity or pretty close to it. The reason they do that is to make the telescope balanced so that you can balance it on these supports. And also, it takes very little effort to point the telescope in the direction that you want. But more importantly, it takes very little effort, and with just a little bit of friction on the bearings, you can keep the telescope pointed at the same direction without touching it. Most manufacturers add nice bearings between the circular supports, called trunnions, and the base of the telescope. It makes for a very smooth operation. The only problem, of course, is sometimes this does not add enough friction and the telescope won't keep its position or direction that you want it to stay. So what they do is they've come up with some very clever techniques for adding friction between the trunnion and the base. For example, on this Orion telescope, we use springs to pull the trunnions tighter against these bearing surfaces. But not too tight, of course. Just enough to allow some small changes in the center of gravity when I install heavier and heavier eyepieces and the telescope holds its position. This Jumel telescope has two ways to tackle the issue. The easiest is the variable friction knob found here and on the other side of the telescope as well. If it's too loose, you just tighten this clockwise and it adds tension to the axle. Top tip. I've found that you can often get away with just adjusting one side of the telescope. In addition to the friction knobs, this one has an adjustable trunnion location. I can unscrew this Phillips head screw and one just on the other side of it. Now, of course, you have to take this out of the mount to do this adjustment, and you can actually slide the whole trunnion axle up and down this mount plate on the outside of the telescope. Unlike the adjustable friction knobs, you have to make these changes to both sides of the telescope. I've seen older similar systems on telescopes such as the older Celestron Starhoppers. Okay. Now, what if you have a telescope that's made out of wood or sonotube? Well, the first telescope that I ever built was a 6-inch dobsonian that was made mostly from plywood. It's slightly nose heavy, so I balanced it by putting a strap across the back and then really just hanging things from it. You could also put a dowel rod back here and drop washers on top of it. That would give you a lot more adjustment. Now, these adjustment mechanisms work really well most of the time, but there will be situations where you have an attachment that is just so heavy that nothing you do can keep the balance. I have the springs on both sides of this, and this is a smartphone adapter. So it is a little bit more than the friction on these bearings can handle. But what if you had an even heavier eyepiece like this one? What if you had an even heavier and newer eyepiece? Let's take a look. Take out the camera adapter. Let's put a really heavy eyepiece in. Now, this is not going to balance. So what can we do? This is where the concept of the counterweight comes in. Now, you may already be doing this. You may be taking big magnets and attaching them to the back of the telescope,
or heavy washers and taping them to the back. But what I do now is I use a magnetic adjustable counterweight like this one. This is a 1 pound counterweight, right? Now I can move it all the way down here for this heavy eyepiece. And you can see that even with basically the heaviest eyepiece that I could find, this little counterbalance works great. And I have it wrapped in a washcloth so that it doesn't scratch up the telescope. It's very adjustable. And one important detail is it has to have enough magnetic force that it stays attached even if it's on a vertical position, right? That's not going to move. So let's go ahead and I'll show you how to make this very cheaply.
Now, you can see these counterweights aren't very big. You can see the rare earth magnets are very strong. Inside here is one of these little 1 pound dumbbells. My kids like to call these baby's first weight training tools. Now, I use the 1 pound dumbbells for my 8-inch telescopes, and anything larger, I use a 2 pound dumbbell. So what I do is I attach rare earth magnets, one to each end. I use electrical tape to wrap them in place. I also use the double stick tape actually to hold them on. But the electrical tape holds them in place really well. And then I wrap them with a washcloth. These are just some old washcloths that we had laying around. The goggles are necessary because we're working with rare earth magnets. You never want to have two of them close to each other because they can snap together and they're brittle. So when they hit, they can actually break apart into very sharp pieces. So make sure you wear goggles. I'll go ahead and put them on now. Let's go ahead and clean up our space a little bit. So this is really all we need. Dumbbell, electrical tape, rare earth magnets, and a washcloth. Let's open up the rare earth magnets. I got these from Amazon, by the way. I think these were 10 bucks, a little bit more. Okay, so they come in this little foam packaging. And there's a couple of double stick pads. More than a couple, actually. Sorry. I can get these out of here. All right, now, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. And they are separated by a little plastic disc. If they were all attached to each other, it'd be very hard to get these apart. So be very careful. Don't get two of them close to each other. Now, I'm going to try to get one off. These are very tight. I'm going to try to get one of these apart. And I'm going to set this over here out of the way. All right. So we have one rare earth magnet with the plastic disc. Let's just attach it to the end of this like that. Right. So apparently these have some kind of steel or iron in them because it is magnetically attracted to it. Let's take a double-sided pad here and put it on the magnet. And peel the other side off. There you go. It's not really going to go anywhere soon. Okay, now I'm going to make sure it stays in its place with this electrical tape. Just going to wrap it around several times. All right. Let's grab one more magnet.
Now I'm just going to repeat the procedure and attach another magnet to the other side of the dumbbell. You can use almost any kind of tape, but I've found that the electrical tape lasts a surprisingly long time for this particular project.
This is a superhero washcloth. That. I found you really only want to have one layer on the bottom, so you go. Voila. You have a magnetic counterweight. Just like that.
Grab your telescope, go outside, and clear skies, everybody. Pretty much every telescope has its